Celtic make only one change, and a very significant one, from Fittodri last week. Back comes Sean Maloney into the starting lineup for the first time since his injury against Rangers. Zaraski is not in the squad at all, but very interestingly, Chinese defender Duvai starts on the bench. Well, Hibs had injury worries over Scott Brown, Kevin Thompson and Guillaume Bouzelin, but all are now fit, and their only change from last week is Stephen Fletcher in for Dean Shields, with Ivan Sproul on the bench. Well, if you applied simple logic to this match, you would say if Hibs can't go to Tannadice and get a point, what chance have they in this stadium? But then that's the logic we applied to Dunfermline a couple of weeks ago, and the rest is history. So in this quirky league we have at the moment, it is best and safer not to assume anything. Thompson, where was he going? Really got into a terrible mix-up there. Nakamura should be put away. It's not. Caldwell is there. Well now, Petrov had a wonderful opportunity there. I'm not quite sure why he didn't hit it with any more conviction. It was Thompson who got himself into needless bother here. Away went Nakamura, did the right thing, and it was played a little too weakly to the goalkeeper's right-hand side. Magidi tries to play it in, and Hodgson didn't get it properly again. Some mistakes that will cost them dearly. Petrov tries a shot. Hodgson is there, tries to get it in. Well, that mistake was made by Bouzelin, and he'll be relieved it came to nothing. Terrible move by Smith here. Can it be laid off? Is Hodgson going himself? Just touched away, and that's going to be a goal kick. Once again, Wallace, Magidi. This is where Celtic have looked very good on that left-hand side. Free kick. And they can't complain about that one. Nakamura, vicious one going in there, yes! Hodgson, would you believe? In the most obvious, and you might even say ridiculously simple way, but that's the value of football. It is a simple game, they say, even the best in a match, and because of this, a club ball, no marking, and a man who's deadly in a situation like that. Celtic are one up. Sliced away, and that'll be a corner kick off Petrov. And Nielsen! Bouzelin gets the equaliser. Across it comes, and watch Bouzelin coming in there. And Petrov, of all people, should know better than that, to get in front of the man. He didn't, and Celtic have suffered in the first minute of this half. One each. Covering up in midfield as usual. Nakamura. More will be expected of him in this half. Capable of turning a game. That great delivery of his and good vision. That's a decent ball in there. It's Hodgson with the header again. Sproul. Still Sproul. Celtic got in the way, and that's his pace is going to be an enormous value to Hibs in this second half. Bouzelin. Fletcher's there. What's he going to try? Oh, it's a beautiful goal! Hibs are in the lead. Fletcher with a glorious shot. He just took that momentary glimpse at goal, and he seemed to strike it with great confidence. He's having a shot. He's any doubt about that. He can hardly believe this. Petrov. Nakamura is almost there. Free kick. Oh, referee waving play on. I think he gave advantage, and now he is awarding the free kick. That was the right thing to do. Excellent play. There's a run forward by O'Connor. O'Connor going in. He's on his own. He tries a little dab at it. I think he should have been stronger than that. Well, Caldwell had to go for that. The goalkeeper might have been a little slow coming off his line. Doing well to part with that. Again, good football by Hibs in midfield. They've got to translate it into something more positive. Just Kral. Kral going to the line, and the goalkeeper got a touch to that. It could have been cut back, and that's exactly what I was saying. If you try that man with the ball, Ivan Sproul, just the simple pace is going to cause tension in the Celtic defence. The fact that he got that goal, he picks that up, he's going for it. Well, that was quick-witted. He saw Boric out of his goal, and yet again we've seen midfielders giving away possession, overdoing it on the ball, as Lennon has got it really caught like that. Giddy looking good. This is what he likes to do, to jink forward. Good understanding as Maloney comes up. Hartson, Maloney, no offside. Then it's played to the side and very poorly by McGinney. The Hibs defence almost taken away. A real blast by Celtic that time. Nakamura. Maloney. Lovely little run forward there, and it's a side net by Petrov. I think that's the first time in the game we've had that typical Petrov run like that, in behind defenders. Well set up by Maloney, intelligent play, and Petrov all off balance. Pressure's still on. Nakamura, can he open it up? Very tight along that 18-yard line. Beautifully chipped little pass that time. And the goalkeeper should get it as Hartson came in very close. And I did say that Nakamura had these touches in a game to change things. That's bad play by Fletcher. Comes fighting back. And he's going to get a booking for that. This could be another dangerous situation with about 7 minutes of the game remaining. Archer lofty on the side of the bar. Almost his hat-trick. Well, here's O'Connor trying to go in for this. With the goalkeeper, here's a great chance for Thompson. And now O'Connor. What a wasted effort. McCluskey. Yes, Brown. Tries to stab it through. What a wonderful chance for Hibs there. Celtic clearing the lines desperately. I think some of these Celtic players were glad to hear the final whistle. Celtic 3, Hibernian 2.